Hello everyone! If you do want to have more freedom at work, or if you are an employer who wants to increase your people's engagement, then stay tuned, because today we're talking about how to give more freedom at work. This is Jim Panos, Transformational Career Coach. I help and inspire professionals across the globe to find their passion at work and transform organizations through well-being. I'm accredited by the largest coaches organization in the world, ICF, International Coaches Federation, and I'm the creator of the Find Your Passion method, a unique coaching tool that can help professionals across the globe to find their passion at work. And I have a vision. My vision is to inspire 3 billion people in 195 countries by 2060 to find their passion at work, because I really believe everyone does deserve to do what they love. And including this, we need more freedom in the workplace. And in a few minutes, I'll just tell you why is it important. So feel free, before diving into, feel free to comment anytime you want, whether you agree or disagree. Feel free to hit that subscribe button if you do want to have access to much more valuable content. And feel free to share this video with anyone you believe they might benefit from. Okay, so let's dive in right away. Okay, so how... before jumping into the details of how you can bring more freedom into the workplace, the most important thing is, first of all, to understand why it's important, okay? It's so important because once you give... People love freedom, okay? We love to have, flexibility and, many choices, okay? Many options, okay? So people love that. And it's even more important at work. Okay, why? Because first of all, you increase your people's engagement, okay? And this is very, very important, because imagine that your people need to be seen, listened to, and understood, okay? This is very, very important. And that's why once you give them freedom and flexibility in their workplace, that they do appreciate that you offer solutions and packages customized to their individual needs, okay? And that's why, because you will respect and understand their needs, they will love you more and they will stay longer, okay? So yes, you also increase your retention rate and you enhance your brand culture this way as well. And that, as a result, attracts even more top talent, okay? Because once you make sure that your top talent stays, then you will be starting attracting new talent, okay, new top talent. So, and besides that, they are more productive. Not everyone, okay, of course, that really depends on every person, but the more you customize the working schedules to your people, the more likely they will be productive. And that does make sense, because it's, every and each of us, works in different ways, okay? So you can have one size, for all solution, but this costs you money, because not everyone will be operating at their 100%, okay? And you do want that. You want to make sure that everyone, is at least 100% in what they do, okay? So productivity is also a great asset. And then last but not least, work-life balance, okay? People have, many obligations, okay? And even if, they don't, they have obligations out of the workplace as well. And again, we, as long as you do provide them the freedom that they need in the workplace, they will do appreciate that for sure. And and as a result, you will help them take care of themselves, and you will show and demonstrate as an employer that you care about their mental health and well-being, okay? Which is, I think it's the greatest privilege that you can consider as an employer, okay? Demonstrating that you care about your people. So what you can do in terms of freedom. So and what do I mean by freedom? Because I need to tell you what I personally mean by freedom, and then of course I'll make my suggestions. So Number one is the working schedule's flexibility, okay? So that basically means that you don't reduce, of course, the amount of time for work, okay? But you adjust, let's say the 80-hour work in your people's needs. So a typical example of this is people who are more productive in the evening, okay? So we have, let's say, two categories, okay? Really, really roughly, because there are more details into this, but we don't have time for that for the moment. So you have your AMers and your PMers. So, you know, from AM and PM. So, yes, there are people who do function better in the morning, okay, early in the morning, okay, but there are also people who are more productive and they function better, you know, in the late afternoon or even in the evening, okay. So you do need to consider that. This is scientifically proven nowadays. So please, first of all, be aware of who is who, okay, who are your AMers and who are your PMers, and just adjust their their workload to their own biological working time, let's say productivity time, okay. This is very important. So this is just one example of the working schedule flexibility. Another one is some people, you know, might have many obligations out of work, okay? So you can, you know, adjust their times to their, you know, own obligations. So, for example, you know, it could be family obligations, okay? It could be some personal obligations, or, you know, just an urgency to pay out some bills, for example, or for any reason, okay? This is not about, the reason and the why, okay? It's about generally making their life easier, okay? So someone, for example, might be easier for them to work instead of 9 to 5, okay, to work 9 to 3 and then 6 to 8, for example, okay? So but this, of course, takes more time, but trust me, you will reap the benefits of it if you do take the time required in advance. This is number one. Number two is location. If someone can do the job, for example, online, give them this opportunity, okay? You will make them a great favor, you know. So many companies right now, you know, they have thousands of employees just online, okay? And this number will just, grow in the next decades, okay? So this is number two. Number three is you can give flexibility, okay, and freedom per project, okay? So what I mean per project, that means that some people can just, and there are many of them, trust me, they can just deliver you the same results they do in less hours, okay? And this is supported by Parkinson's Law, who said that people complete their assigned tasks or, you know, job in the time available for its or their completion. So it's all about, you know, how much time does someone have, okay? So that doesn't necessarily work for everyone, but for many people, you know, and in the last study and research, we have seen that most employees in the UK, they said that they could actually do the work, required by them in less time, and that can mean less hours during the day or even less days during the week. So they could be working for 4 days instead of 5 or 6, okay, or even less. So try this out per project. It can really, really make a difference for you. And then we have also another thing you can do is take care of the inclusion part, okay? By inclusion, I mean, do they really have a voice? Or just, it's all about giving them the opportunity to be listened to, and that's it, and then only the senior or the leader decides. No, the best ideas should win, okay? Not the best position, okay? Or the highest position, okay? This is what I mean by inclusion, okay? And this is freedom of not expression, but of voice, let's say, in the workplace, okay, of having a real impact. And then initiatives, okay, freedom of taking initiatives. Do you encourage them to, you know, think differently and take initiatives? Or do you have, you know, a very hard bureaucracy that, you know, impedes them from creating and, you know, innovating, okay? And innovation is key if you want to grow your business, okay, and make it sustainable, you know, over the years. So, you know, these are just a few suggestions, but they can really, really work for you. And last but not least is all about personal projects, okay? So if someone, you know, wants to do something that, you know, seems irrelevant to their current job or role, okay, doesn't matter, give them their own personal time, okay, during their working hours to work on that, okay. And you know, as long as, of course, there is some link between their work and generally, you know, the services and the products of your organizations or your company, okay. But that will allow them to express themselves, and it's quite likely for them to create products and solutions that they would have never ever created of them under you know, different circumstances, okay. So you can give them 5% or 10% you know, of their weekly working time just for this, or 20%, you name it. But that can also make a great difference, okay. And make sure that you assign them tasks that make sure that you will encourage them to take on projects that they are really passionate about, okay. So this is it. I hope that you did like this video, and if you did like our video, give us a like to our Facebook page, Jim Panos Coaching. And here, remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel to have access to much more valuable content, and feel free to share this video with anyone you believe they might benefit from.